Hello, my name is Shridhar Srivastava and this is my podcast. So in this podcast, I want to talk about the importance of not making a perfect plan. I know there are a lot of people who just think that if they make a perfect plan, they will get successful. And that's the truth of life as well, which I have also realized that if you do the things to the level of perfection, they will work out for you. But there is also a thing called you will learn with doing something. Like I have also made a YouTube channel where I could have made tremendously good videos with lots of editing and doing lots of things, but the thing is I just wanted to start somewhere, because for a very long time I was trying to initiate my YouTube videos and try to just keep on making YouTube videos, but there was a lack of motivation because every video that I made required some kind of effort, and there was a tremendous amount of effort for which I was not getting anything. YouTube does not pay you well, and YouTube also has this condition that they need 1000 subscribers and 4000 hours before they actually start paying you money. So I didn't cross that barrier, and before that barrier was crossed and I started earning money from it, there was no way I was going to start it. Basically, if I would just wish about it that I wanted to do something and I would do it perfectly and I would spend so much time trying to hone my craft, how would I know whether I have honed the craft, whether I am good at something? I have been to places and I know some people who have been working very hard in improving themselves, but until unless you test what you have done, you will never get successful. I was reading this book, and in this book, I don't remember the name of this book, but there was an example in that book about this gaming company in which they developed a game, and they didn't tell about this game to anyone. They didn't went to the beta testing or the alpha testing. They just created the game because they thought the idea was great, and for like 2 years they kept on working on that game, and they spent more than $1 million to $2 million just to develop that game. So after 2 years, when they called people for testing, the people kept getting up and leaving the room. So they asked few of them that why are you leaving the room, are you not interested in the game, and they told that the game sucks and the game is not very good, and they were surprised and they were highly demotivated because they have invested so much energy, so much money, so much time into making that game. And then they realized something. They realized that after every stage on which they were developing the game, they should have tested it, only then it could have become better. And that is the whole process of doing something. You keep doing something again and again, and that is how you get better. If you do not try something, you're never going to get better. Even if you start with imperfection, even if you start where you are, you don't need a perfect plan all the time. You do not have to gain all the knowledge in this world. You do not have to gain all the art in this world, or the talent in this world, or you don't have to even have anything to just begin. If you just start doing something, there are chances that you will find it entertaining, and on the way that you started doing it, you will find the ways to improve it, and eventually this is going to improve. What people think that whenever they are going to do something, it is going to be so perfect, it is going to work like miracle. That never happens. A lot of filmmakers have bad films behind them before they start making their good films. A lot of writers have years and years of bad writing, where they just keep on writing stuff that just doesn't work before they actually start writing good stuff. And that has also happened with me, because I also write a lot. Initially, when I used to write, people used to just figure out all the mistakes that there were in my writing. There were grammatical mistakes, there were syntax errors, and the story was not good, and the flow of the story was not good, and so many people have pointed all these things to me, and they told me that you are not a very good writer, and they kept on demotivating me, and they said, why don't you improve, why don't you read more books? But I have read so many books, and I still don't know why my writing didn't improve with that. But the thing is that it was only later that I realized that for becoming a good writer, I have to write more. The more I will write, the better I am going to get, and the more I will edit on what I have written, the more better it will look. So that is how I learn the things. So basically now when I start doing something, I just don't wait for some right moment to come, some perfect plan to come, or I don't try to just hone the skills where I would reach to a level where I would just become perfect and then I will start doing something. It is good that you plan something. It is good that you hone your skills, but there has to be a limit to that. Like there are so many people who spend years and years trying to gain some perfection in their field, but at a one time they have, when they go out in the field and start to do it, they realize that they are not very good at it. So right now when I'm making this podcast, I decided that I'm going to make 100 podcasts in English, because my English is not very good, and I used to make videos in English only, and I was not very comfortable talking in English. And right now, I'm not very comfortable talking English. there are many other channels that I have also made in which I talk in Hindi, and I am very comfortable talking in Hindi because my mind only works in Hindi. I have to convert everything that I am saying from Hindi to English to tell you. And I want that, I know this, that if I make 10 minute videos every day as a podcast and let's put it there, then I will improve my English. And this is what I am doing. I am trying to be as good in English as possible. I am trying to put words into my mouth which can be distinctly be heard by you, because I have this problem where I overlap with words, I say things very fast, and I have to get over that problem. I have to get over this problem where when I speak, people actually listen to me, and this is what I have to do. That I have to speak, and the more I will speak, the better I'm going to get at it. I'm not waiting for reading a lot of books and trying to do a lot of things. No, I'm just practicing. I'm just practicing, and I'm practicing as I'm going along. And every day that I do this, I can promise you, I feel this improvement inside me. Like, I also have a channel in which I am doing riyaz, because I always wanted to become a singer, a good singer. And I know that before doing too much hard work, I cannot become a good singer. So I have decided that I am going to, and I was not too particularly motivated to do the riyaz every day, because I couldn't keep the track of it. I was not motivated because there is no physical award that I am going to get to become a good singer. And maybe I don't want to become a singer by profession, I just want to sing because I like to sing. So I kept a track of the riyaz that I do every day, and I make a YouTube video out of it and put it on YouTube. I don't popularize it, I don't put it on my social media, I don't want people to even know about it. I just make one riyaz video and put it every day there, so that eventually my voice is going to get better. And similarly, I am doing this thing with this podcast as well, because I every day I am talking in English. I think I am improving the flow of my English, and also improving my punctuations. I am improving, and I can see that. I can hear myself, and when I hear myself speaking on this particular things, and I have this goal that I will talk for 10 minutes. Like, it is right now, how much minutes it is? It is like 7 minutes 22 seconds for which I am speaking. And sometimes I just don't know what I want to speak. Sometimes I just pick a topic and just start talking about it, and there's not much for me to talk, but I still keep on talking, and that is the most important thing. So I have seen so many TED talks also. Right now I can think of this one TED talk by Mithila Palkar, where she says she didn't have any plans about doing anything, she was just doing what she liked to do, and eventually turned into a successful venture. So that is all that also happens, that if you just keep on doing what you really want to do, it will take time, it will take some time for you to become successful, but eventually you're going to become successful if you keep on doing the thing that you really want to do. And that is what I am also doing. I am just doing the things that I, and sometimes I'm just forcing myself to do the things despite I don't want to do those things, like these kind of podcasts which I'm making in English. Sometimes I have this resistance inside me in which I don't want to make this podcast, but I know it is very important for me to make this 100 podcasts of 10 minutes each. Imagine I have made 100 podcasts of 10 minutes each, which means I have talked for 1000 hours continuously in English. Isn't that going to improve my English? No matter how many films I will watch, no matter how many series I will watch, no matter how many books I will read, there's no resort to which I can escape from this hard work of talking. I have to talk to become good at it. There is no escape from that, and I know that. And I can also tell you that if you want to start doing anything, like if you want to do writing, then you fucking start to write. If you want to make a film, then go ahead and make your film. If you want to start painting, then go ahead and make the painting. If you want to meet someone, just go ahead and fucking meet them. If you want to propose to a girl, just go ahead and fucking propose to her. What is the big harm in doing that? There is no harm. She's just going to say no. What is the big deal about it? There is no big deal about it. So you just keep on doing things that you really want to do, and I think that is what makes all the difference. So I have decided that I am not going to wait for the time when I'm going to get perfect. I will eventually become perfect if I keep on doing this. There was something in my mouth, I don't know what it was, but anyways, so don't wait for getting perfect. Just keep on doing things till you become good at it. Even though it does not make sense in the present, it will definitely make a sense in the future when you will see what you have done to become what you really wanted to become. So it's 9 minutes and 44 seconds, 46 seconds, and I'm waiting for it to reach to the level of 10 minutes so that I can stop this video and stop blabbering and boring you with the same nonsensical talk that I'm doing for the last 10 minutes. And trust me, I have nothing to talk about. I just wasn't thinking. I don't have enough examples to give you right now. When I write these things, if I write about this example, then there would be so many things that I can write about it, because I've read so many self-improvement books that I can talk about it for hours. But right now I'm not very comfortable in front of the camera talking in English. I'm very comfortable in front of camera when I'm talking in Hindi, but when I'm talking in English, I'm not very comfortable. Like right now, there are so many words that are just getting digested inside my mouth without coming outside in the way I want them to come. But still, this is what I'm going to improve. This is what I'm going to do. This is what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to be better at talking in English, because that is very crucial for the industry which I'm in, which is a film industry and writing industry. It is very important that I keep talking and I keep getting better. And this is my advice to you, that you also follow this advice and just keep doing what you want to do. And eventually, if you do it, you are going to become successful. And that is a promise from my side. So let's close this podcast as of now, as I'm bored of talking, but since it is an exercise in talking, that's why I'm doing that. So we'll meet in next podcast, and if you are watching this podcast right now, I would like you, and if you have reached this far, that you have listened to me for 10 minutes just blabbering nonsense, then I would suggest that you watch my 100th video, which is eventually going to come, yes, in the future. So I'm sitting in the present, I'm talking about the future. That you see my 101st podcast, and you will find the difference in the talking that I'm doing, and then you will realize what was the point that I was trying to make. So let's meet in the next podcast, and we'll soon meet at the 101st podcast. Goodbye.